You have so many recordings, Ajit, today. You'll have to. Now, sum if is, it combines if function and the sum function. So, depending on a condition, if you want to add something, use the sum if function. Right? It's a very powerful function. Allows to add up values in a selected range of data that meets a specific criteria. If portion will determine what the criteria is, and the sum part will do the addition. Okay. There's another one called sum if s, where you can put up to 127 criterias. Okay, it's a really powerful one. So a lot of people, they use only the sum if s without the sum if. Even for one condition, you can use sum if s. Okay. This is the syntax. You can see the sum range is optional. Sum range is optional. Now we have to see why that is. I'll show you. Sum range is the actual cells to add. What is the range that you want to add? That is called the sum range. In the criteria is, you know what it is. It could be a number, expression, cell reference, text, or a function that defines which cells are to be added. That is the criteria. The condition. Then there's a thing called a range. The range of cells that you want to evaluate by the criteria. Now, when you say that your criteria is customer abundance, that means the range is customer. Because how, where can you find abundance is in the customer range. But you are adding the invoice total, then your sum range is invoice total. So let's take example and see. Now, sometimes you can see this is optional. This is omitted. It assumes that the criteria range and the sum range both are same. There can be situations like that. Both ranges are same. You're checking the something and adding that same thing. I'll take an example like that. Look at this data. These are syntax. Sum all quantities less than 100. Now, what is the criteria? Less than 100 is the criteria. So, what is your criteria range? Where can you find less than, whether it's less than 100 by checking which range? Invoice number, date invoice, customer, outlet, code, quantity or value. By checking the quantity. I mean, obvious, right? To find whether the quantity is less than 100, you have to check the quantity column. Right. Now, what do you want to sum? Again, the quantity. So, your sum range is also quantity. Both are same. Now, this is one instance where you check that quantity and add the quantity. I am going to find out the sum of all the quantities less than 100. Both sum range and criteria range are same. Then you don't need to put this sum range. It assumes, if you don't put it, it assumes both are same. So, that's your range. Criteria is quantity less than 100. Sum range again is the same. Right? So this is your sum if G6 to G26. The criteria is within brackets you have to put less than 100. Remember that. Okay. Now let's see how to advance this. Without putting this within double quotes and within inside the bracket, if you want to change it from outside, you can put these two separately in two cells. So next time when you say type 200 here, it will give the total of less than 200. Right? If you say greater than, then it will say greater than 100 or greater than 200. You can change from here, automatically it will give the total. Very powerful. To do that, make sure you put this in two different cells and then the change is this. You simply, instead of this less than 100, you simply put G3 and H3 and we'll combine these two and give less than 100. But you don't have to put double quotes now, right? You don't have to put double quotes now. Okay, let's do another one. Sum all quantities of abundance. Now, can somebody tell me what is the sum range? Yeah, just give a try. No one is speaking up. What is the sum range? Quantity. Right? Quantity is the sum range. Why? Sum all quantities. So obvious, sum quantity. What is the criteria? Abundance is the criteria. So what is the criteria range? Where can you find abundance? In custom. So this is your criteria range. Now two different things. This is your sum range. And the criteria is abundance. Range is customer. Range means the criteria range. Criteria is abundance. Sum range is quantity. So here you are. You put abundance within double quotes, or you can refer a cell address for this. Again, you can put abundance, it will give the total of abundance. So here I put M12 instead of abundance. So M12 will have, you have to type abundance in letter cell M12. See another one. Total value of invoices before 1st of May. Range is date invoice. Why? How can you check whether it's before 1st May? From the date invoice. So that's your range. Criteria is date invoice less than 1st May. Sum range is the value. So here we are. You put within double quotes less than 1st May. Or simply you can say less than within double quote and say and C3. That's how you combine these. Right? Or you can say and today. So always it will be less than today. All the total of all the invoices less than today. Right? So I think look at this one. Sum if S. Sum if S first comes the sum range. In the sum if first comes the criteria range. It's multiple dhaan ke first ten ne sum range. Ke ita pas se criteria range 1, criteria 1. Criteria range 2, criteria 2. Like that you can go up to 127 criteria. Look at this. Total value of anchor sold by Amal in Gold District. It has to be anchor. It has to be sold by Amal. It has to be in Gold District. I have 3 criteria. So I can't put sum if. I have to put sum if S. Right. Total value. So what is your sum range? Value. E6 to E14. E6 to E40. Then criteria range 1. Anchor. Anchor thiyenne mokada product kiyanne. So product is a B. B6 to B14. Product. Criteria 1 is A3. What is A3? Anchor. You can put, refer a cell address. Criteria range 2 is rep. That is this column. Criteria is this cell. Criteria range 3 is this column, the district. Criteria 3 is C3. So, let's do exercise. Let's open. Then only you will see how powerful this is. And we will finish with that. Number 9D. Can you open number 9D? Number 9D. Open number 9D. Go to the first sheet. Sum if. Right? Here. Sum all quantities less than 100. Let's do a separate totally. So here all the answers are given in this view. You can check for those. So I'll do one and show you separately, right? When you click here, you can see the formula. It's hidden. That's right. Right. So you can try these things at home. But let me say, my question is, sum all find the total value for kills in goal. Find the total value for kills in goal. So what is the the criteria is what? There are two criteria. It has to be kills, it has to be in goal. Right. So let me type kills and goal somewhere. Right. That's easy, no? I'm doing a fresh one because this is already done for you. You can already refer that. I'll say the customize and outlet. I'll type it here. So later you can put any customer, any outlet. Right. Customer and outlet. I'll say kills and I'll say goal. For these two, we can put, if you want, you can put but data validations, right? So that you can pick. This is where I need the total. Let me merge and center and widen this column. I need the total here. So I put the sum if here. Equal, can I put sum if? No. I have put sum if S. Open bracket. Sum range is value. Select this, comma, criteria range 1, kills. Kills is the criteria 1, no? So kills is in customer. So range 1 is this. Go with the help at the bottom. Criteria is whatever I type here, kills. Criteria range 2 is outlet. That's a range, comma, criteria 2 is here. But only thing, now you can see it's hidden because of my formula. So I'll type the letter M21. It should be M22. Right? The cell address here. I can't click it because that column is not wide enough. That's all. It's 144,000, whatever. This is my total. Now I'll say Abans. Goal. That's AI. So let's say Abans. Where do we have Kalutara? You get the photo. See how powerful this is. Let's say Haley's Candy. Haley's Kalutara, Haley's Candy. Keeps on changing. Right? So that is called SumIf. I'll do the count if also from this, because count if is much easier than sum if, because it has only always one range, the range that you count. Count if S will have multiple ranges, right? Let's say I want to count. Now this is the sum. Huh? This is the sum. And I want to get the number of invoices into this. I want the total and the number of invoices here. Let me select both and put it to center. Number of invoices. You have to put count if. You can't put count if. You have to get put count if S. Why? Because there are two criteria. So count if S, open bracket. Criteria range 1, criteria 1. Because always you are counting the range that you are checking. Counting means how many items are there. So criteria range 1 is what? Customer. Right? Criteria range 1 is Elise. Criteria range 2 is outlet. Criteria 2 is this. There are only 4 invoices for Haley's Candy. Can you see? There are only 4 invoices for Haley's Candy. And the total is this much. If you really want to find out whether it's correct, go to filter, go to Haley's, right? And then go to outlet and filter it only for candy. There are only 4 invoices, it says. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the total, you want to find out the total, select this. What is the total here at the bottom? 179,859. Right? Let's remove the filter. 179,859. 175.59. So that's sum if and count if. You get average if like that. Very powerful, very useful. Okay. Right. Let's start on PowerPoint. Any questions on Excel? What we covered? So this is the sum if, count if, sum if s, that's what we did. And there are some error functions, so is blank, is na. These I think you can learn on your own if you go to the help. I'll just show you just one and tell you how to calculate that. Let's say with the same thing I'll do it. I have some, let's say, quantity value, let's say total or something, which is equivalent to equal this into this, right? The total. Now sum here, I may have a let's say accidentally I have a text here. What happens? It comes with error. For some reason it comes with error, either division by zero or let's say the total is not this, and then divide by, we'll put up just a formula, right? 34 into 5%, something like that. It's our formula. So yeah, right. Now here I have a zero. Then here I have a text. You can see it's coming with two different errors. Sometimes when you do calculations, there may be errors. So how to avoid errors? What you do is this formula, you put in a thing called, what do you want to do if it's error? If error, value, what is the value of this formula? Whatever the output of this value. When you say if error value, value if error, no. Value means the outcome of this formula, if it's a formula. So I'll take it. So what do you want to do if it's a error? Either you can display a message saying please check, or simply you can put a zero. If it's error, put zero. That is how you handle your errors. Otherwise it looks ugly, no, here and there, division by zero. All right. So if it is error, now when you copy it down, you can see these two errors will become zeros. Right? So that's if error. Okay. We'll stop with that and let's move on to, it's a very useful function, these handling errors. Let's move on to PowerPoint. I was told that everyone is using PowerPoint.